Hi, today I'm going to be showing you how to install a PiAware operating system onto your Raspberry Pi. Basically what PiAware does is it automatically feeds flight signals to the FlightAware website. So what you'll need for this is a Raspberry Pi. I'm going to bring the screen over here. What you want to do is get a Raspberry Pi. It doesn't have to be Model 3, it can be Model 8, or sorry, Model B, as long as you have a Wi-Fi dongle. You need a power supply. You can need a FlightAware stick, you need an SD card, antenna, and that's pretty much all it is. You also need a micro SD card reader. I think these are all optional. I recommend this, otherwise I would just get a FlightAware Pro Stick Plus, which is what I have. So first of all, what you want to do is go ahead and download the PiAware software. So I'm going to not click this, but normally what you do is click that and it would start downloading. I'm going to cancel this because I don't need it. So once that's downloaded, it will go into your downloads. So let me go into that quickly. And it will come up as PiAware SD card, and it will be in a zip file. So you want to click that and extract all. And then once it's extracted, you want to just save it somewhere which you'll know where it is. So let's just save it to my SSHD. Somewhere in program files, and click select folder, extract it there. I'm not going to extract it now, but what it would normally do is come up somewhere wherever you left off. Mine's just in downloads, but normally wherever yours would be extracted, the folder would be there. So you want to hit that, and then you want to also install a program called Etcher. So Etcher, what it basically does is it formats a whole drive. It formats a drive and installs things on it, and this is a completely virus-free thing, of course. So you want to make sure that that's your SD card. Your SD card should normally be on a D drive, which you can check here, PiAware D drive. I've already got all my stuff downloaded on here, so I won't need to do that, but you can click continue, and you want to select your image, which you can go ahead and click your downloaded thing. Wherever that is in my downloads, that should be. PiAware SD card, that's what you want to hit, and hit that. And then that would completely format this drive and download this onto it. I'm not going to hit it now, but normally that would just do that. You also have to make sure that you're not like clicking anything, because if you click that button and it's the wrong drive, it's going to completely destroy your computer. So I'm just being a heads up. Make sure it's your right SD card and the right download, so the right download, right SD card. So normally once that's done, it will say, I think it says verifying 100% when it's done. You will get it on an SD card. So what you'll do on your SD card is, if this is where you want to decide if you're on an Ethernet cable or a Wi-Fi dongle. If you're on a Wi-Fi dongle, you want to go ahead and hit config. Sorry, that's not the right one. Where is it? PiAware config. Okay, so you want to go to network configuration. You want to go ahead and click wireless network, yes. Yep. And you next want to go ahead and go to wireless SSID. I'm going to blur all this out, but normally here you do your what's-his-face, your wireless SSID and your wireless password. You should put a space between it, I think. And then once that's done, you're good. So you can exit, well, actually don't exit out of that, click file and save. And then you can exit out of it. Next, what you want to do is just, this is all fine, you want to eject the drive, so hit eject. And it's safe to remove the hardware, and I'll see you on the Pi. Okay, so now I'm in a better place for radio signals. So the first thing you want to do is go ahead and find your flight stick. I've got a FlightAware Pro Stick Plus and your 1090 MHz antenna. So I've just got a new ELEC one. I'm going to screw that on in there until it stops rotating. So right about there, and then you want to stick it upwards. And then you want to go ahead and find your Raspberry Pi. I've got a Wi-Fi dongle in this. There's my old NMAX one, and you want to plug that into the bottom one, and you want to grab your flight stick and put that in the top one. And then you want to find your SD card. I have my micro SD. I've got the files on this micro SD and I have an adapter, so I'm going to plug that in there. If I can get it in right. There you go. And now I'm going to wire everything up to the TV. Okay, so now that your Raspberry Pi has a HDMI cable plugged in, which is quite easy, it's just in the side, you want to make sure you have a TV, and I'm going to plug my PiAware in now. And let's hope it all works. There we go. And if it displays that, it's pretty much good for the software side. Move this camera a little bit. And this is just about nearly booted. And yep, okay. So it should say this for a second, it will all be red, so don't worry about that. That's good. So you got the PiAware feeder and the receiver at normal, that's really good. FlightAware feed normal, and a multilateralization, if it's on warning, it's just saying it's initializing. You can just wait for that to go to normal. Zoom in a little bit so you don't have much glare. And that shouldn't take too long. Okay, it's pretty much initialized now. So if it's still on warning, it just says no clock synchronization, it's pretty much fine. It's just collecting all the data from nearby receivers. So you can pretty much take the HDMI cable out now and go back to your computer. Okay, so now you have your Raspberry Pi plugged in. You want to go ahead and go back to this link and you want to hit this. So if it's all plugged in, and obviously it said earlier that it was connected to the internet, you want to click that. I'm not going to click it now because I already had my Raspberry Pi claimed, and it should come up with this success logo. Once that's done, well, if it doesn't, you just want to click refreshing a couple of times and then you can contact support if it doesn't work. Here you go ahead, it tells you here. You want to go ahead after that is done and you've claimed it, you want to go back to Google Chrome and you want to hit your Raspberry Pi's IP address. I'm pretty sure it starts off, well, it should tell you what your IP address is when you start it up, but mine is 192.168.1.224. Hit that, and if everything is green, that's amazing, everything's good. You want to hit go to map, and then you've got all the planes around your area. There's a little key down here, that's roughly about 15,000 feet maybe, no, it's 10,000 feet, but. And you got all these planes and everything at this point should be good. You're claimed, you can go to your FlightAware stats, I believe. My ADSP. This one is broken, so I don't use that one. So yeah, you have your, if it says live, that's good, less than a minute ago, it's also good. Here you go, this is where you find your IP address. You can go to the FlightAware website and it'll say down here. So click that and then it has that. So thanks for watching, guys, and I hope you learned something today, and I'll see you another time.